Hi everyone, welcome and thank you so much for joining us. I'm going to talk about a Kubernetes-based workload allocation optimizer, which is designed to minimize the power consumption of computer systems. We are Ying-Feng, Kazuhiro, and Morito from Osaka University, and we are so delighted to be here at KubeCon Cloud NativeCon North America this year. Here is the outline of my talk today. First and foremost, I'm going to tell you a little bit about ourselves, then I will give you a brief intro and the background of this proposal, which is about the challenge of increasing power consumption in data centers. Then I will introduce the detail of our proposed approach, a Kubernetes-based workload allocation optimizer. We name it as WAO. WAO includes WAO scheduler and WAO balancer. They work together to perform the optimal task allocation. So eventually, it achieves the goal of data center power consumption reductions. You might be interested about what is WAO's performance and how much data center power reduction can be obtained by using our proposed WAO. We will show all of this based on an experiment of using 200 servers in our private data centers. Finally, the conclusion will be provided at the end of this talk. So who are we? We are members of Matsuoka Laboratory at Osaka University. Our research mainly focuses on the field of data center energy saving. Our work always starts from building real testbed data center and operate them on 24/7 basis. Actually, this proposal is based on the infrastructure of two data center sites in Osaka City. So after data centers are set up, we install various of sensors inside the data center, and then we collect all detailed power consumption related data from those sensors, as well as the data from packaged air conditioner and the data from all the servers. By using this data, we use technology such as building machine learning power consumption models on each server and CFD simulation technology to reduce the data center power consumption. We have developed several data center power reduction techniques in our laboratory. One of example like this figure was using liquid immersion cooling technology to reduce system temperature. We have also used machine learning techniques such as deep learning to predict data center power consumptions. Based on accurate power consumption prediction, an optimal task allocation plan can be generated. Because the user's request is dispatched based on this optimal task allocation plan, so eventually the power consumption of the data center can be controlled and reduced. The method proposed in this talk is to extend the concept of the optimal workload allocation in this slide to Kubernetes architecture. Due to the rapid increase in network services, cloud edge computing system management has become more complex than ever. Besides, the increase in total power consumption of cloud edge computing system is another critical issue. In this session, I'd like to talk a little about the background of this proposal, which is the challenge of increasing power consumption in data centers. So, with the massive increase in IoT devices and the demand for 5G networking, the amount of computing resources required has also increased dramatically. Edge computing using 5G networks may reduce the communication time, but meanwhile, the management tasks are also becoming more and more complex. Also, the significant increase in the usage of cloud edge computing systems has led to increase in power consumption. Kubernetes provides container orchestration solutions with functions of container deployment, monitoring, and scale management. Many Kubernetes extensions have been focused on high-performance container orchestrations on large-scale networking environment. However, the current Kubernetes does not provide the container orchestration from the perspective of power consumption reduction. and there are relatively few discussions in the community on how to operate containers at runtime while consider both energy saving and the service performance. For example, it will be great if we can consider various of application requests as well as different capacity and the performance of computing resources before microservice deployment. Okay, now let me talk about our proposed approach, the Kubernetes-Based Workload Allocation Optimizer, WAO, which consists of the components of WAO Scheduler and WAO Load Balancer. So in this proposal, we extend our WAO Workload Allocation Optimizer to the Kubernetes platform for power consumption reduction in data center. We have proposed several versions of WAO in the past. The main concept of WAO is use machine learning to predict server power consumption and perform optimal task allocations. In other words, we create power consumption model using machine learning method. Then we, with this prediction result from the power consumption model, WAO allocates tasks to the server with the least amount of the increased power consumption. So actually, in the next session of this talk, we will show how WAO achieve excellent power consumption reduction in data center. This talk presents a WAO workload allocation optimizer that manages the microservice container based on Kubernetes architecture. In Kubernetes, pod is the smallest deployable unit and consists of a single or multiple containers. And node can be either a virtual or physical machines. For task or allocation on Kubernetes, first the kube scheduler distributes pods to the nodes, and after that, pods process users' requests. The kube scheduler consists only resource status of each node, and the MATLB provide the basic load balancing solution for Kubernetes clusters. In other words, there is no any power consumption concept taken into account in this process as we mentioned earlier. To realize the power consumption reduction on Kubernetes, our approach consists of two major steps. First, we develop WAO-based scheduler. We name it WAO scheduler. This is for the pod allocation and WAO-based load balancer. We name it WAO-LB. It is for the task allocation. After that, tasks are allocated to pods depending on request from the client. Regarding to WAO power saving operating, as we just mentioned, kube scheduler allocates pods by considering resources of the system such as the CPU and the memories of each node. MATLB is a young project which acts as a simple load balancer by using standard routing protocol. As for our proposed WAO, WAO scheduler provides the power consumption priority control, and WAO-LB can manipulate task allocation priority between power consumption and response time. Now I will explain the architecture of WAO scheduler, especially PCS. After taking the available nodes list from filter phase, PCS first collects information on each node, for example, resource usage such as CPU usage in Kubernetes cluster, which is aggregated by metric server, and temperature around node, which is obtained from each node. After collecting those information, PCS predicts the increase of power consumption of each node using TensorFlow serving server. Finally, PCS scores each node by using the predict power consumption increase and determines the optimal node for part allocation. So, through this whole process, WAO scheduler is able to perform part allocation considering the power consumption. For the WAO load balancer, the WAO-LB, it gets the part allocation periodically using Kube API server when receiving a request from a client. WAO-LB first collects information about each part, such as CPU memory and network status from C advisor. Then WAO-LB predicts the increase of power consumption by PC model and the response time use RT models. Both models are based on the TensorFlow serving server. By utilizing those information, WAO-LB is able to perform part allocation based on the trade-off between the power consumption and the response time. As I just mentioned, WAO uses two machine learning models, the power consumption model and the response time model, to determine the task allocations. I'd like to briefly explain the design of these two machine learning models here. First, both models are based on neural network. We have tested other types of machine learning models, such as SVN random forest, and we found neural network has the highest accuracy among others. After hyperparameter tuning, we choose Adam as the optimizer for both models, and the final design of the power consumption model has one hidden layer, while the response time model has three hidden layers. So now, you might ask, what is WAO's actual performance, or what level of data center power reduction that you are talking about? In this evaluation session, I'm going to give you a demo example. Based on operating of using a 200 server cluster in our private data center, we have just introduced our WAO for the purpose of data center power consumption reductions. It wouldn't make any sense without considering the performance, which is the responding time of the microservices. So how does it work and how is the WAO's performance? Actually, to verify this, we set up an experiment in our private data center. Inside the data center, we use about 200 SenseSpec of servers for this experiment. We choose an object detection application to evaluate the performance of WAO. Object detection is widely used today, such as security camera, self-driving car, smartphone application. So we believe this use case is suitable to represent our work. This application is about up on receiving an image. The AI model run by microservices will search and add annotations to the images. So this is something like the photo in the slide. Air conditioners usually consume the most power consumption in data center, and the temperature of the data center also dominates the total power consumption of that data center. As the first step of our experiment, we investigate the relationship between the power saving and the preset temperature of the air conditioner in data center. In these figures, the horizontal line shows the preset temperature of the air conditioner, and the vertical line is the difference of power consumption increase between WAO scheduler and the default Kube scheduler. We found that the preset temperature was 24°C, WAO scheduler reduced more power consumption than other temperature settings. So in fact, server fans also has high impact on power consumption. At temperature of 24°C, server fans started to rotate, and this operating caused the increase of power consumption. Therefore, we adopt the temperature of 24C for the experiments of WAO scheduler and for WAO LB. This 3D figure is the result of server power consumption model in this experiment. The horizontal line indicates temperature around the server and the CPU usage, and the vertical line indicates power consumption. Blue lines are predict value from power consumption model, and the those green points are the real values of the test data. The most remarkable finding here is that the server's power consumption increased significantly when the CPU usage was between 10% and 30%. In the proposed WAO, other than using power prediction model to predict the increased power consumption of servers, we also create a response time model to evaluate the response time of applications. In order to meet operating requirements of applications, while LB use an evaluation function to determine the priority of task allocations. The parameter of alpha and beta in the evaluation function are weights of index, and this value can be changed depending on the application requirements. For example, for application related to self-driving, low response time is critical. On the other hand, for non-real-time related applications such as sensors that observe the weather for a long time, lowering power consumption can be prioritized. In this demo experiment, we choose an object detection application and we observe that a correlation of negative 0.569 between increased power consumption and the response time. Okay, let me start from talking about our evaluation plan of Kubernetes-based WAO for data center power savings. As I mentioned earlier, WAO consists of WAO scheduler for pod allocation and WAO LB for task allocation. We use default kube scheduler and the metal LB as default baseline comparison matrix. Then, three combined effects of both WAO scheduler and WAO LB can be derived here. In other words, we like to see how much power saving can be obtained from our WAO by comparing with the default Kubernetes baseline. The first evaluation plan is about finding the power saving from using WAO scheduler with metal LB. In other words, we like to find out how much power saving can be obtained by replacing kube scheduler to the proposed WAO scheduler. The left figure shows the dynamic of total power consumption from all of 200 servers in this experiment when WAO scheduler or default kube scheduler allocating the pods. This result is based on pod allocation of 10, 30, and 50 pods at the with different level of the CPU usages. Obviously, the total power consumption increased with the increase of pods and the CPU usages. Here we can summarize three observations. The first one, WAO scheduler achieved power savings regardless of the number of allocated pods. And the second one, the highest power reduction rate happens when operating on 10 pods. As you can see from the right figure, compared to the default kube scheduler, about 8% of power reduction was achieved at the total CPU usage of 20%. In the third observation, we find when there are more available resources such as idle CPU, WAO scheduler will achieve a higher degree of power savings. Next, let's see how much power saving can be obtained by replacing default metal LB to propose WAO LB. In other words, we like to see the performance of power reduction from setting of default kube scheduler plus the propose WAO LB. This figure shows the power consumption when WAO LB and metal LB allocated tasks. The horizontal line shows the total CPU usage, and the vertical line indicates the total power consumption. As for the WAO LB, we examine with three different patterns of the priority between power consumption and the response time. Those patterns are the first one, prioritizing only increase of the power consumption. And the second one, prioritizing only responding time. And the last one is equal prioritizing both increase of power consumption and the response time. When power consumption is prioritized, as shown in the yellow line here, while LB achieves more power saving compared to the metal LB, the green line. Precisely, it is about 9.9% of power reduction at the CPU usage of 20%. Lastly, let me show you the full WAO solution, which is combined effect of both WAO scheduler and WAO LB. This figure shows the power consumption result between the proposed WAO, which is the combination by using WAO scheduler plus WAO LB and the default Kubernetes solution, which is based on kube scheduler plus the metal LB. So compared with the default kube scheduler and the metal LB, the complete WAO solution reached about the maximum of 13% power consumption reduction at the total CPU usage of 27%. And in this figure, we summarize the power consumption saving behavior of WAO. We can see that the WAO scheduler and the WAO LB reach over 12% of power consumption reduction at the total CPU usage between 15 to 39%. So actually, in general, server utilization in a typical data center is often between 20 to 40%. So this result tells us that the proposed Kubernetes-based WAO can achieve its most of its power consumption reduction under the common data center CPU usage scenario. We also evaluate WAO in terms of the response time. Otherwise, it doesn't make any sense for a cloud edge computing system by only talk about its power reductions. Each box plus shows the response time when applying WAO LB with three different priority settings. The vertical line in the figure is response time, and the horizontal line shows the CPU usage from 10% to 50%. As we can see here, in the most of comparison scenario, the WAO LB has lower response time for task allocation than a metal LB. When looking at its balanced mode, it reduces the power consumption and the response time than the default metal LB task allocations. Most importantly, WAO LB supports priority adjustment between power consumption reduction and application response time requirements. Here is my conclusion. This talk is about a workload allocation optimizer WAO that extends Kubernetes platform to realize power consumption reductions. WAO uses WAO scheduler for pod allocation and WAO LB is designed for task allocation. Both can be used to reduce data center power consumptions. And when using both, WAO could reach about 13% power consumption reduction compared to the default kube scheduler and metal LB. In addition, WAO LB provides application priority control mechanism, so it can meet the response time requirement of each application and obtain power consumption reduction under such priorities. This is all about my talk today, and thank you for joining us again. I'd like to take any questions from here. Thank you.